Hi, I'm Judy and I will show you the calibration procedure of the Turbimax CUS51D. The CUS51D is pre-calibrated on leaving the factory, but should be calibrated on site for solid content measurement. In this video, we will carry out a 3-point calibration, although for some applications, a 1-point calibration might be sufficient. For this, please refer to the operating instructions. As the sensor works drift compensated in a wide range, a calibration on a regular basis is not necessary. All the more, the calibration must be carried out with due care and attention. Therefore, please provide the following devices and tools: a lab stand, a magnetic stirrer, 3 black buckets with a volume of at least 5 liters, and a bigger bucket with a volume of about 10 liters. Apart from that, the customer should provide a device for solid content measurement as reference. Before you start to work, please remember, wear always your safety equipment, your safety glasses and your chemical resistant gloves. Now we can take out the sensor for the calibration. Now we start with the preparation of our samples. As the calibration has to cover the complete measuring range of the process, we will prepare a serial dilution with 3 concentrations: a 100% solution, a 50% and a 33% solution. The concentration of the original sample should be as close as possible to the upper measuring range. If this is not the case, as in our example here too, we have to increase the concentration of it. Therefore, we prepare the sample as follows. We take a sample of about 10 liters and wait until the particles settle down. Then we remove unnecessary water to get a higher concentrated sample. Now, with this concentrated sample, we can prepare our serial dilution as follows. For the dilution, we can use tap water. After preparing the serial dilution, we take a small sample of each concentration to the lab to determine the reference value. After preparing the samples, we need to prepare the sensor as well. Therefore, we take a soft brush or a sponge and clean the sensor with water. While doing so, never touch the optics with your fingers, as you will leave oily marks on them and thus disturb the measurement. Now we are ready for the calibration itself and can continue with the Liquiline CM44. Push the calibration button at the CM44. Select your sensor channel and confirm the subsequent options until you get to the calibration menu of the sensor. Now we create a data set which will store our calibration data. We enter data set to select an empty data set, which are indicated by an empty square. Now we specify a name. And select a suitable application model according to your process. If you are not sure about the correct application model, please refer to our operating instruction chapter application. In our case, we take the excess sludge model. Now we enter calibration table and add calibration points. Then confirm with OK to start the calibration. Before confirming the next step, it is very important that the sample is well mixed, so please put it on a stirrer. Then we have to immerse the sensor as follows. Please ensure that the LEDs are directed towards the middle of the bucket. This is very important to prevent air bubbles and to avoid wall effects before we press OK. It may take some minutes for a stable measuring value. Please don't take out the sensor. When the calibration was successful, the following menu appears. Here we see the current measuring value and the nominal value. For now, we keep the nominal value until the lab value has been determined. Now we can add the next calibration point by selecting Calibrate Next Assay and follow the procedure as previously. After all calibration solutions have been measured, we select and press Accept Calibration Data. Our calibration data are now being validated and stored in the sensor. Then we can press OK to finish it. However, due to the missing lab values, our dataset is not ready for activation. So here we press Escape. Here are the lab results. Great, let's go on. To complete the calibration data set, we go to Calibration Table, Edit Table, and enter the lab values in the nominal value column. Then we press Save. To finally activate the calibration dataset, we go to Menu, Setup, Inputs, your sensor channel, and application type, where we select solids. Then we go back to application to select our dataset. Then we press escape for a longer time to get back to the measuring screen. Check if your calibration was successful by measuring the samples. The values should be close as possible to the lab values. After this quick calibration check, the calibration is completed and the sensor is ready for operation. Thanks for watching this video, but there's even more to come, so stay tuned. Hey, and if you find this video helpful, like it!